What's up, guys? It's your boy Kris KeyZ, and welcome to my channel. We talk about music, money, and mindset. And today I'm going to give you my top five updates to Logic Pro 11.1 update. Also, stick around to the end because I have three extra bonus features and updates I'm going to share with you. First of all, thank you, Logic Pro, for listening to us. We've been asking for this update for so long, so thank you for finally giving us what we want. But also, I feel like Logic took the best of all the DAWs that are out there, the popular ones like Pro Tools, Fruity Loops, Cubase, whatever's out there. And I think they just took some of the best features from all the DAWs out there and incorporated that into this new update. So without further ado, let's jump right into my favorite updates in Logic 11.1. Here we go. Number one, let's talk about rearranging in the mixer window. So for so long, say I was working with the tom here, and say I wanted to move my bass or something over, I couldn't do that before. So now all you have to do is you can click on the track, just hold it down, and now you can, or one or two, once it pops up, you can now move tracks in your mixer. Rearrange your mixer. So helpful, so useful. It's so cool. Like I said, you just click on it, and once it moves around or pops up, you can now move it. Another cool thing you could do, say I have, I want to click here. I can hold down Command. I can click that one. Say I hold down Command again. Say I want to hold down this bass. And now I could just, while holding Command, I can click on it and it moves them together. And now I can move those however I want. So another really cool feature of how to rearrange your mixer. Once again, all you have to do is hold down Command, select the tracks that you want, and when you get done with it, just hold down and it moves them all together, right? That together. And once again, you know the hotkeys. If you want to do anything, just press Command Z, and that takes you back, undo what you've done before. All right, let's move on to number two. Oh, that was really three. Number three, I really gave you two already. But the next feature is a new plugin that they gave you. So you can click to X here. So you can go to a new plugin. But hey, let me show you one of the features of how you can do it. They've added a search tool to Logic now where you can search. So I can click on, say, effect right here, and I got a search tab. So I can go to, say, a compressor, and boom, I like that I can search my compressor, all my compressors pull up right there. So I don't have to go in and find my compressor and, where is it, dynamics, all my, like I don't have to do none of that no more. Oh, compressors here. No. Just go click on whatever you want, go to the search tab, and it does it right from there. And another cool thing is, say I have my compressor here and I add it here. So what I could also do is, say I want a sidechain, boom. I used to have to sidechain, find what I'm doing. See, look at all these tracks, man. It'll take forever, and especially if you're not a guy who labels everything. So now I could just go out right here to the search, and I can go kick. Boom, right here. If I want to go to the snare, I can sidechain. If I want to go to a guitar, or let's see, I think I named it Nord. So I have the key. So that's another very cool feature, which is going to just improve and speed up your workflow using the search tab. All right, next update they gave us is, once again, I can go to Reverb. They gave us a new Reverb, guys. So I can go over here to, let me take this off, Reverb, and it's the Quantec Room Simulator. So this is another cool reverb you can play around with. But you have your reverb time. Let me see if I can actually, let's put it on the snare here. Let's go snare. I'm just gonna solo this, and I'm gonna go to my quantum reverb again. Oh, let's just search it, reverb. I'm gonna add this on my snare, and I'll just play a little bit, say right here. Very cool reverb. You have the Quantum QRS and the Quantec yardstick. So two different reverbs. You can play with the drive. You know, and this is nothing. I wouldn't use this, but I'm just really exaggerating so you can hear the difference. And it has like a little EQ. So definitely worth playing around the new plugin, your Reverb Quantec plugin. So thank you for that update. Let's keep it moving. Another new update you can do is, say you're a person who, we just have a lot of ideas, I'm writing with a songwriter, and they're in this room, and you're creating together, you can share this straight to a voice memo now. So say I wanted to bounce this down, usually I would go bounce project or something like that. So now, if you want to share it to a voice memo, you can just go to share right here, and then you can go song to voice memo. So you can share your song to a voice memo. So you just go right here, you put in whatever it's called, you have a couple options right here. I press share, boom, it'll go straight to your voice memo on your iPhone. Now this does require you have the iPhone 16 Pro settings. That's what it says, but it might work if you have something similar a little bit later, maybe the iPhone 15. I'm not sure. But on this update, it is a very cool feature that you can use to bounce down your tracks or your song, and it goes straight to your voice memo. Like I said, it's right here. I got mine synced up, and it goes straight to my voice memo. So very cool update right there. Now, since we're talking about bouncing songs, here's your next update, where you have now your bounce in place feature. This is a feature I use all the time when I'm creating and producing songs. I want to bounce something in place. Say I have a MIDI something or audio and I want to chop it up, reverse it or anything. They gave you a couple new features. So obviously I like hotkeys, so you can go to Control B and bounce in place. Say I click on my piano, my Nord down here. I can usually go to Control B. And what they have now is a couple more features. You have the one file per track, one file per region. So usually it'd be one file. So you would bounce that down. So now what you can do is, let's just get out of here real quick. Let's just say I want to bounce this keyboard and a bass and a snare. Usually before, when I would bounce it, it would all consolidate into one track. So now the options you can do, press Control B, that'll pull up your bounce regions in place. I could do bounce one file per track. So what this is going to do now is take all of these tracks that I have and individually bounce them on tracks, so you don't have to consolidate all your tracks in place now. So once again, so you can see it's individually bouncing these tracks separately together. And like I said, I have the option to mute it, the track that I did bounce before. So another very cool feature, I'm going to undo this Command Z. But let's just say I have, let's just say, let's just do, I'm gonna select all and let's get my scissor tool. And I'm just gonna chop this up a little bit. Say right here, let's just give these a few chops, all right? So now that I have this chopped up in different regions, I can now go to the same thing, Control Bounce. Let's just choose a couple things. Say I want to bounce this one down, bounce this one, or just want to bounce this whole. Let's just do this. Bounce these three right here. So I have three different tracks highlighted, but you see how they're all chopped up? I can now go to my Control B, bouncing region, and I can go to bounce one file per region, right? Press OK, and check this out, guys. Now it's going to individually bounce your tracks, but separate it by a region. So if you're a person who likes your stuff kind of chopped up and bounced it in a region, Logic, thank you so much. Another very cool feature that you can use right there. All right, now let's get to some of my bonuses here. And like I said, this update has way more than this, but I'm just going to give you a few. We could call this part one, right, of Logic Pro update. Let me just undo some of this right here. So now one of the next things you could do is, on your, if you press X, You see, you have this mastering tool right here. Sometimes when I say go to my window, if I want to add something, I accidentally hit this mastering tool and it starts mastering. So what you can do is you can go get rid of that by going to your file logic. You can go to your settings, Logic Pro settings, and you can go, let's just press general so you show you how to get to it. Just go up here and then go to view, and then you see, go to mixer tab. You have your general tracks and mixer. Go to your mixer tab and you see where it says show mastering assistant button. You can click on that and then you see the mastering, that tab goes away. So if you're creating or mastering, if you don't want to use that particular AI mastering at the time, just go into your settings and you can take that off. Really simple right there. All right. How you loving me? Let's keep it going. Let's keep it going. Another cool thing that you can do is they added, let's go back. I'm going to press X to get out of that. On your control bar, a lot of times if you want to change your sample rate, you can go to customize control bar. And what I did to get to that, I just pressed go in this little area, kind of double click or right click, and you can go over here to add sample rate. So we said display, you can go to sample rate, and now you have your sample rate and buffer size. Because right before, like I said, to get to this same thing, it was just time consuming. So Logic Pro, they're speeding up our workflow. Ain't nobody got time to be messing around, because time is money and money is time. And I don't have time to waste either, right? So you click on that and you can change your sample rate or see what it is right there. Because before, you had to go to Logic Pro settings or go over here to general and change everything, audio setting, buffer size. That's just too much to do. So thank you, Logic Pro, for adding that setting right there. So once again, guys, these are just a few of my top updates that they have in Logic Pro X. But I'm going to show you one more. Now this one is, go back here to the Windows or to your, press X to get to your mixer. So let's just say I have a couple effects on here. I'm just going to add a couple. Let's just add a delay, a compressor. Let's just add a couple things, right? So let's just say I'm working and before I have to go over here, no plugin. Well, guys, you don't have to do that no more. Just hover over the plugin and press command, and you see how that little eraser comes up? Press that, boom, click on it. It erases the plugin right there. So click on, hover over your effect, press command, boom, gone. Easy. Workflow. I'm creating like way more songs now with this simple Logic 11.1 update. So, and once again, guys, you should be able to do this with multiple plugins at the same time. So let's just say I put a compressor on these three tracks together. Let's just say they're all highlighted. I just go up here and they all disappear once they're highlighted. So once again, I hope these tips, tricks, and hacks help your workflow. If you enjoyed this video, man, please subscribe. Hit the like button. It really helps the algorithm and dishes this out to other Logic Pro X creators and users. And I'm pretty sure they will appreciate you for that as well. So on this channel, once again, I cover three things that will help your music career, but also in life. That's music, money, and mindset. Guys, this is what we do. These are three essentials to help your career. So thank you guys so much for watching. Until the next time, y'all know what it is. It's Kris KeyZ. Peace.